Given that the government has known about the potential job losses at Qantas for months, what is the government's plan to support 5,000 Qantas workers who found out they've lost their jobs today?
The last thing I'm going to do today is to play politics or to try to make capital out of what is a very difficult day. I grieve with the workers who are facing an uncertain future. I am right when I say that there will be better days ahead in a stronger economy when workers can get the jobs they need.
When will the government act? Will the government provide a standby facility to Australia's national airline?
We want to ensure that Qantas is not competing against its rivals with a ball and chain around its leg. That's what we are trying to ensure. But the difficulty, Madam Speaker, is this. What we do for one business, in fairness, we have to make available to all businesses.
Does the Prime Minister stand by his comments of today that workers' entitlements, the Deputy Prime Minister, that workers' entitlements at Qantas are responsible for some of the job losses that have occurred today?
I do not blame the workers. I do not blame the workers for the fact that technology has moved on, that aircraft don't require as much servicing as they previously did. I don't blame the workers for that. And it is simply beyond dispute that Qantas is faced with the difficulty of having to compete with airlines in countries where the wage structure is very different from what it is in Australia. That's not the fault of our workers. That's not the fault of our workers. It's a reflection of the fact that there are lower wages paid in other parts of the world.
I refer to ongoing speculation since early December that the government would offer support for a standby facility. Prime Minister, what will be the implication for Qantas jobs, Qantas share price, Qantas shareholders, if that speculation does not result in action? And when will the government act to support Australia's national airline?
What this government is determined to do is to ensure that, as far as is reasonably possible, there is a level playing field for competition and that Qantas is not competing against its fierce rivals with a ball and chain around its leg. And we'll help Qantas by saving it some $270 million in carbon tax costs over 2 years.
Given the Prime Minister's tenacity fighting for the job of the Assistant Health Minister, and given the Prime Minister's failure to outline any plan to support Qantas workers today, why won't the Prime Minister stand up and fight for the 5,000 people who found out they've lost their jobs? And why won't you fight for the rest of the jobs and keeping Qantas majority Australian owned?
The whole point of government is not to guarantee every single job. No government can do that. No government can do that. The point of being in office is not to run a checkbook government. The point of being in government is to get the fundamentals right.